with, say, cheap MP3 players, like for instance this one. By the way, no complaints about this MP3 player. It worked very, very well. Want to demonstrate that. But with cheap MP3 players, it could be that when you look at the signal on the oscilloscope, you see, say, a kind of bubbles, or you see that the audio signal is remastered in a certain way. It's sampled. That means that there are traces of square wave present in the audio signal, and because such an amplifier or an audio amplifier compensates that, due in fact to its say non-linearity, often non-linearity, it corrects in a certain way such sampling signals. But anyway, you can remove these, say, sampling bubbles. I call it bubbles, but I want to show on the oscilloscope exactly what I mean. You can remove them. That's what I found out today on the basis of this two-stage transistor amplifier. It's purely experimental. That means that you can set the amplification here and here. You can set the bias here and here. Or in other words, the working point. That in fact doesn't matter much that you can change here the bias. For when you want to use fixed value resistors in the base voltage divider, use here a 27k resistor and here a 10k resistor. But I've made it variable because this is a kind of demo circuit with which I make many videos for YouTube. So that's the aim. Here the decoupling unit, always necessary by the way, but important what it was all about. And that's this capacitor here that does the job. It removes, say, sampling elements that are at the same time on the audio lead, the line level lead. So it's amplified here, true and true. And you will see them on the scope, but often not hear them. Perhaps when you are specialized in audio electronics, you will hear it, this sampling. But anyway, this capacitor does the job. It's a 10 nanofarad capacitor, and I can only advise to do experiments, for instance, with this capacitor and that capacitor, and also with this capacitor, the capacitor that does the job. Of course, what you do here now is filter it out in a certain way. That also means that you have the loss, a loss of high frequencies. That's completely sure, and that will depend on the value, how much high frequencies you will lose in this part of the circuit. Depends for the biggest part on the value of this capacitor. So when, for instance, you use a 100 nanofarad capacitor, perhaps the sound will be kind of dull. Anyway, want to show it? Here is the test circuit. Here the signal tracer, the loudspeaker, and here my cheap MP3 player. Let's listen. then look at the scope. It's important to look at the scope. Here you see the scope signal. Amplified somewhat. And now I'm gonna remove that capacitor that does the job, taking out the sampling. Here is that capacitor. Take it out. And you can see immediately that this audio signal consists of a kind of sampled or broken signal, and you often don't hear that when you listen to audio. And I'm sure many people are not able to detect it with their ears, just like me. I also don't hear it. I don't hear the difference. But when you switch on that capacitor here, 10 nanofarad, you have a completely smooth signal. And do you hear it? Let's test it again. And by the way, you can hear that you don't lose too much high. This is music from the 127 terz. You can hear also here in this case, also here, all these breaks inside the music signal. And now I connect that capacitor again. So that was all to tell. It's a way to make the signal, the audio signal, the line signal of an MP3 player more smooth. Though I can't almost hear no difference, perhaps a somewhat sharper high when the signal is not corrected. But anyway, I think it's an interesting circuit. And of course, you can do a lot of experiments with it by changing, for instance, the amplification here and here. Changing the bias has also an effect, though a very slight effect, because the bias must always be set to a proper value. So there's not much room for change, but with this potentiometer in the emitter lead, you can set the amplification of the first and the second transistor, and that will surely have an effect also on the sound, the quality of the sound, and the sound spectrum.